List data sources. In many cases, you want to show more than one record or the data related to one record via lookups. In these cases, like for instance on an opportunity, you probably want to show a list of all products related to this opportunity. So quite a list. What you want to show is the product name and the quantity. So I have a demo document prepared in which I want to repeat this row for every product that's actually linked, or every opportunity product that's linked to our opportunity. How we go about that? Let's start with creating a data source. New data source, of course, of type Sokol, as always. Data source demo list. Now, very important, change the type to list so the system knows that there are multiple records possible here. Let's save it. Now the data source is created. Let's create a query and we'll use the Sokol builder to create that query. Okay, now we filter on opportunity products. So we want to get a list of all opportunity products related to the opportunity. So after the filter is done, might take a couple of seconds as this is a huge list, as you can see, of documents that are there or objects that are there. So opportunity products is here. If you want to check it, it's the opportunity line item in API mode. So this is the right one. Let's select that one. And now we get the opportunity ID, of course, because that's a filter record. We need to filter on that one to know that we have only selected the opportunity products related to our current opportunity. We have the opportunity product name. Okay, let's select this one instead of going via the relation. We have the quantity. Okay, add a field. So we add a filter. We say that the opportunity ID must be equal to the record ID. So that's the record we're currently working on. It will be the ID of the opportunity. Add the filter, go to review, and we see a perfectly okay Sokol. So let's use that one. Now we have selected our opportunity line items or our opportunity products, and we add the Sokol here as well. So it's the, let me see, where is my query that I need? This is the one, so it will immediately know that quantity is a number, so that's fine. And now let's generate our configuration. Product name, I just copied that one, add the configuration. Product name, it's a table row. Yeah, the data source is this list, of course. The merge field is the product name, that's fine. Then under product name, let's rename that maybe to TR product name. Okay, so under this one, we for every row that it has to for every record, it has to create a row. So that's what we said now. Now we want to say when this row is created, what does it need to do? It has to fill in the product name from the parent data source. So we know that we are on a certain record. From that record, take the data, the name of the opportunity product, and okay, let's fill that. And let's create a second one. And this is actually the product quantity. Okay, so product quantity, let's take the quantity. Let's not do any formatting for now. That's not a part of this demo. Product quantity, okay. Save to server. And now let's test this. Let's go to our car sales opportunity. If I take a look at my document, document is already there. Okay, just the opening, and you see that it's a perfect list of all of the opportunities that I wanted to see with their quantities. Okay, so that's it for generating a list data source, which is pretty cool. So we have done the single now, the list, up to the next one.